Can we talk? A guide to tough conversations with your boss. Editor's note, a version of this story appeared in CNN's Work Transformed newsletter. To get it in your inbox, sign up for free here. It can be hard to admit you need help, especially to your boss. You don't want to seem unproductive or inefficient. But let's be honest, work right now is tough. We've all got a lot on our plates, juggling the demands of both work and life in the middle of a global pandemic that has gut-punched the economy. And while managers should be regularly checking in on their team members, we can't expect them to read our minds. Open communication is crucial to workplace success. But how do you start? If you are having a hard time working from home, don't just approach your boss and say, "I'm struggling." Identify the specific problem that needs to be addressed. Here's one phrase an expert suggested using when asking for help in order to be most productive: "I need." You're worried working from home could stall your career. If your colleagues have gone back to the office and you're still working from home, you might worry that being out of sight means you're also out of mind. And to some extent, that's true, one expert warned. You're going to have to be proactive when it comes to staying on the radar. Determine how your boss best likes to communicate and set up regular check-ins. For some, daily emails with progress updates and plans for the day will suffice, while other bosses prefer weekly video chats. You can also use working remotely to your advantage. For instance, working from home might mean you can work the later shift and be the bridge between the East and West Coast offices. You are nervous about going into work. If the idea of heading back into the office makes your palms sweaty, you aren't alone. Experts recommended being open about your fears and offer solutions that might work for you, like an office with a door, an early start time, or a desk in a more secluded area. Here's the thing to remember: this is brand new for everyone. And the only way we can figure it out is if we are talking and working together. Click here for more advice on having tough conversations with your boss. Sure beats a thank you card. Amazon is thanking its workers with bonuses. The tech giant, which has seen explosive demand during the pandemic, is handing out more than $500 million as a thank you bonus to frontline workers who were with the company throughout the month of June. The size of the one-time bonuses depends on the job. Full-time Amazon and Whole Foods employees, along with drivers for delivery service partners, will get $500, while part-time employees or drivers will get $250. Frontline leaders at Amazon and Whole Foods will get $1,000, and delivery service partner owners will get $3,000. Amazon Flex drivers who logged more than 10 hours in June will get $150. The rewards come after the company decided to eliminate a $2 hourly wage bump and double overtime pay for frontline workers at the end of May, reports CNN Business's Sarah O'Brien. The company has also faced increased scrutiny over coronavirus-related safety measures. Can street vendors solve China's unemployment problem? With worsening unemployment and a stalling economy, China is looking for a way to help get things back on track. One idea: street vendors. Millions of them. It's a quick way to bring back jobs. One city allegedly created 100,000 jobs overnight by setting up tens of thousands of street stalls. Vendors usually sell items like fresh vegetables, food, and clothes. But not everyone is on board with the idea. Some worry that street vendors' conflict with the image Beijing has been cultivating of an advanced global superpower. Read more about the divide here. White male privilege and racial inequality. The head of one of the best-known philanthropic organizations says it's time for white male executives to acknowledge how their privilege has held black workers back. "We have to recognize that privilege, which is basically a status that most white men in this country enjoy, is a barrier. Their own privilege is a barrier to our advancement," Darren Walker, president of the Ford Foundation, recently told CNN Newsroom's Poppy Harlow. "White CEOs," he asserts, "are often blind to the talent around them because of their own privilege and background," reports CNN Business's Jean Sahadi. "They don't see themselves in a black executive," he said. You can read the story and watch the interview here. Coffee break. Looking for a little cash and need to clean out your closet? Well, I have some good news. The second-hand clothing market is growing, while the broader retail sector is expected to shrink, according to CNN Business's Parija Kavalins. And if you have certain in-demand brands, including Fry, Kate Spade, Tory Burch and Coach, hanging in your closet, you could be sitting on a resale goldmine. Click here to find out more about which brands have good resale value. Click subscribe to receive the latest news.